Welcome to my YouTube channel. Please be sure to subscribe to my channel and also do not forget to press the bell icon so you never miss any video tutorial published by me. Welcome back to my YouTube channel Conquest Biology. Today let us discuss TCA cycle, Krebs cycle or tricarboxylic acid cycle. All these terms are synonyms. So we learned that in pyruvate dehydrogenase complex like PDH complex, we get acetyl coenzyme A from pyruvate. So now today let us discuss what happens to the acetyl coenzyme A produced in the PDH complex. Once acetyl coenzyme A is produced in pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, then it reacts with oxaloacetate. All this happens in mitochondria itself. Pyruvate dehydrogenase complex is also in mitochondria and TCA cycle also occurs in mitochondria itself. So the acetyl coenzyme reacts with oxaloacetate. Oxaloacetate is a 4-carbon compound and acetyl coenzyme, as we already know, it is a 2-carbon compound. Both of them react in the and the reaction is catalyzed by an enzyme known as citrate synthase, and the process is known as condensation. So basically what happens is they both combine to form a, because it is a 4-carbon compound and it is a 2-carbon compound, so now they both combine to form a 6-carbon compound, which is citrate. So that, and this citrate molecule has carboxylic acid attached to each carbon. It has a backbone of 3 carbons, and to each carbon one carbon, this is carboxylic acid group COOH. So to each carbon one carboxylic acid is attached. So that is why it is known as tricarboxylic acid cycle, because citrate is formed in this cycle and it is a 6-carbon compound with a backbone of 3 carbon atoms to which 3 carboxylic acid groups are attached. Now the second step in the reaction is formation of isocitrate from citrate. So this reaction is catalyzed by a reaction known as aconitase, and during the reaction first of all dehydration occurs. Dehydration means loss of water, and an intermediate compound is formed known as aconitate. I'm not writing it because it's not that important, intermediate. It is just like an intermediate which is formed in between the formation of citrate and isocitrate. And after dehydration, again hydration occurs. That means water molecules comes in. And the reaction is catalyzed by an enzyme known as aconitase. Then isocitrate is formed, which is also a 6-carbon compound, as shown in these dots. Now the third step is formation of alpha ketoglutarate from isocitrate, and this reaction is catalyzed by isocitrate dehydrogenase. And the reaction here, oxidative decarboxylation occurs. In pyruvate dehydrogenase complex also we learned about oxidative decarboxylation. Decarboxylation means removal of a carbon atom. So a carbon atom is removed in the form of carbon dioxide, and a 5-carbon compound is formed, which is alpha ketoglutarate, because 1 carbon has been removed. And also this is a very important step, because in this step we get 1 NADH. So basically we get 3 NADH molecules, which are very high energy molecules in TCA cycle. So we will learn now where, in which of these steps they are formed. First NADH is formed during formation of alpha ketoglutarate from isocitrate. Now the fourth reaction is oxidative decarboxylation. again oxidative decarboxylation occurs. That means removal of one more carbon atom occurs in the form of carbon dioxide, and the reaction and alpha ketoglutarate is converted into succinyl coenzyme A, and the reaction is catalyzed by an enzyme known as alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. Now, one carbon has been removed. So now, succinyl coenzyme A is, it is a four carbon compound. Now, that was the fourth step. Now, in the fifth step is, and during this reaction also, during step four, also another NADH is formed. So far two NADH molecules have been formed. Now, the fifth step is substrate level phosphorylation, which occurs in the presence of an enzyme known as succinyl coenzyme A synthase. And succinyl coenzyme A is converted into succinate, which is also a four carbon compound, because this is four carbon compound because no carbon is being removed from here. So number of carbon atoms will remain the same. So GDP or ATP are converted into GTP. So we get GTP or ATP, which are also energy molecules. Why this is known as substrate level phosphorylation? Because here the ATP or GTP are not being formed from GDP and inorganic phosphate. Inorganic phosphate is Pi. They are not being formed like this. The phosphate group is being transferred directly from a substrate. So that is why it is known as substrate level phosphorylation. So that was the fifth step. Now the next step is, the sixth step is formation of fumarate from succinate, and the reaction is catalyzed by an enzyme known as succinate dehydrogenase. And here dehydrogenation occurs. So let me tell you this, what is dehydration and what is dehydrogenation? Dehydration means removal of water, whereas dehydrogenation is removal of hydrogens. So that is the difference. Here from succinate, only hydrogen is being removed, and fumarate is formed. So there is no removal of carbon. So this is also a four carbon compound. So that was the sixth step. Here also an important high energy molecule is produced, which is FADH2. Now the seventh step is hydration, that means addition of water, and fumarate is converted into malate, and the enzyme which catalyzes this reaction is fumarase. So that was the seventh step. We can see here water is being added over here. So that was the seventh step. Now the eighth step and the last step of TCA cycle is conversion of malate into oxaloacetate again. And the reaction is catalyzed by malate dehydrogenase. And here also, in this step also, dehydrogenation occurs. That means hydrogen atoms are removed from malate and oxaloacetate is formed. So that's how oxaloacetate, which was consumed with acetyl coenzyme A, is regenerated over here. So now if we count also the acetyl coenzyme A, which is produced here, when it combines, only CH3 C double bond O reacts with oxaloacetate, and rest is C. COA, coenzyme A is sent back to the PDH complex, because PDH complex also requires it. We learned about it in pyruvate decarboxylation. So it happens. So this is also regenerated. This is for pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. Now if we talk about energy molecules, then we will, so this is here, this is third NADH is also produced over here. So overall we get three NADH from TCA cycle. We get one FADH2 from TCA cycle. FADH2 has energy equivalent to 1.5 ATP molecules, and we also get GTP or ATP. Actually, this cycle was first of the was noticed in pigeon. So in pigeons, GTP is formed, but in humans, ATP is formed. So we write both the things. So now, if we talk about how it is very difficult to remember all these intermediates, so there is a mnemonic device to remember them. Let me tell you how we can remember it for a longer time. Let me write it down. So this is a mnemonic device to remember this. OA, can I keep some sugar for madam? Now let me compare it. O is for oxalic acid because it is also starting with O. Can, C is for citrate. I is for isocitrate. K from keep is for alpha keto glutarate. Sum is for succinyl coenzyme A. Now you must be wondering whether this S is for succinyl coenzyme A or succinate. Now we can see that this succinyl coenzyme A has S as well as O. So that means sum is for succinyl coenzyme A. And sugar is for succinate because it doesn't have any O. So SU is for succinate. Now 4 is for fumarate. And last, madam is for malate. So this is the mnemonic device to remember TCA cycle. So that's how we can remember tricarboxylic acid cycle easily. And they're intermediates basically, because we get confused what will be, because for now if we are reading it, yes, we can recall it. But for a longer time, if we don't revise things for 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, then we tend to forget it. So we can remember all the intermediates using this mnemonic device. So the TCA cycle, which I just discussed now, in that TCA cycle, we were talking about only one acetyl coenzyme. But we know that in pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, two acetyl coenzyme A are produced. Like we started, if we talk about glycolysis, from the very beginning, from glycolysis, there was one glucose molecule which produced two pyruvate molecules. Now in the two pyruvate molecules produce two acetyl coenzyme A. Now two acetyl coenzyme A in TCA cycle, what they will produce? In the last discussion, we were saying that 3 NADH, but they were produced by only one acetyl coenzyme. But if we sum up both the energy produced from and the product produced from both the acetyl coenzymes, then we will get to know this equation. This was the input, 2 acetyl coenzyme A were used. Although oxaloacetate was also used, yet it was regenerated. So we input only 2 acetyl coenzyme A, from which 6 NADH will be produced, 2 FADH2 molecule will be produced, plus 2 ATP, plus 4 carbon dioxide molecules. We noticed that in two steps decarboxylation occurred. So 2 carbon dioxide molecules were produced from 1 acetyl coenzyme A. So from 2 acetyl coenzyme A, 4 carbon dioxide molecules will be produced. So during, when we exhale, we exhale out this carbon dioxide only, because this is the byproduct of cellular respiration. It is forced out of our body and we inhale oxygen. So that's about tricarboxylic acid.